Today we're going to talk about the new updates in version 22.4 Premiere Pro that was just released this month in May of 2022. Now last month I made another update video on version 22.3 that had the massive new UI updates to the import, edit, and export workspace in Premiere Pro. Now this new update has mixed reviews. If you want to go check out all of those updates, you can just click right up here to watch that. Before we jump into all of the new updates in 22.4, I want to share with you things that I would love to see in Premiere Pro that are not in this version. Now, I've already sent this to the Premiere Pro team, so they're aware of it, but I really want to have my channel be a space where people can share feedback to the team, and I just don't want it to be, you know, empty negative feedback like,
Premiere Pro sucks, it's super slow.
I want it to be constructive so that way we can move forward and really make the software even better than it already is. So here are the four things that I want to see that are top of mind. One, in the new export workspace, I'd love to see on the right a new area for us to be able to select a sequence preset, because right now it just takes the aspect ratio and it will just create a sequence in that aspect ratio. But what if you want to create a sequence in a vertical format? I'd love to see a drop down there so we can just select a preset that we've previously made. And two, why is masking so hard in Premiere Pro? I previously made a video on this and everybody was blown away that I could actually scale a rectangle proportionally. Like, people had been using Premiere Pro for 10 years and they didn't know how to do this. And one thing that you still can't do easily is just create a proportional square. It's the most basic thing and we can't do that. And three, we need to have a video remover for the video, not for the audio. So that way you can just drag and drop it from the effects panel onto your video to remove any grain or particles in the background, especially when you film at night and you get a lot more noise in the video. All the other NLEs have it built in. You shouldn't have to purchase a plugin for something so basic. And fourth, the ability to nudge shapes and text using the arrow keys, just like in Photoshop, pixel by pixel. Because right now I can't drag a text precisely. I wish that I could just use the arrow keys just to, you know, move it just a slight bit over. It would be a huge time saver. So if you have anything else you'd like to see, be sure to leave a comment below and make sure that it's constructive. That way it can be more of a space, an ecosystem where Adobe can see what you need and we can just improve and reiterate on the software. All right, so now let's go ahead and jump into the new updates for version 22.4. The first update is you can now export a GIF with transparency. So here in Premiere Pro, I have this motion graphic here of what's new in Premiere Pro, and you can see it has a black background, but it's actually transparent. And if you didn't know this, you can actually go to the wrench tool and change it to transparency grid so you can actually see that it's transparent behind the text. Now, from the workspaces, you can click on export, or you can use the shortcut Command M or Control M if you're on a PC, and it will take you to the export workspace. If you want to export a GIF from the format, you're going to select animated GIF. And from the video tab here, if you open this up, you can have it match the source. If you want to customize that, you can uncheck this and you can choose custom, and you can make the resolution smaller here if you would like the file and file size to be a little bit smaller. But I don't recommend going too low because then the actual GIF looks a little bit too pixelated. So I'm just going to keep it as match source. And down here, this is the new thing, transparency. You can choose dithered, hard edges, or none. So none is no transparency. Hard edges actually looks the best, but you can see that the edges are a little bit jagged, and dithered will actually use a limited color palette. So you can see some like white specks inside. Depending on the GIF that you're working with, you kind of have to compare them, but I think the hard edges looks better in this case. By the way, welcome back. I'm Kelsey. And if you haven't subscribed yet, be sure to subscribe as well as hit that thumbs up icon if this video is helping you out so far. And if you don't know yet, I do some live workshops. I'll put a link down below, but they're essentially a space for us to get together. You can ask questions live and I can get more specific into your workflow. You can join there. It's just $10 per month to join. Go check it out with the link below. And lastly, I want to thank today's sponsor, Envato Elements. And what I love about Elements is everything is unlimited. So you can download anything that you want any number of times to use in any video. And I especially love all of the Premiere Pro templates, the Mogers that they have, all of the After Effects templates, and they have a whole lot more. They have sound effects, they have music. You know, I don't want to tell you about it. You know, let me just play this song that I wrote. It'll explain everything.
When you're stuck and you're not moving forward, Envato Elements is the place for you. You get unlimited downloads, freedom to explore, templates, photos, music, just everything you need in Envato Elements. Yeah, the new way to create.
So I hope that you liked my Envato Elements song. By the way, if you want to know how I made that hologram effect, you can just click right up here to watch that tutorial. But don't forget, you can get 70% off your first month of Elements by using my link below. All right, let's go into the next update to 22.4. So the next update is in the Essential Graphics panel. It's best described if I actually show you how it works, but it has to do with being able to distribute objects and text evenly. I think it works best for creating patterns and equal distances. So in this case, you can see here, I have a repeated pattern. So if you want to make like title, graphic, animation that has something that's said multiple times or different things on each line, here I have what's new in Premiere Pro, but you can see I wrote it out just quickly, so everything was uneven. What if I want to get it all into a straight line? This is where I can select the first layer, hold shift, and select the last layer. And now you'll see that there's a transform box around each of the layers. And it's blue, that means that it's selected. So down here under align and transform, you'll see that a few of these are recognizable. For example, if you want to align all of these, align the center horizontally, you can select that. And what this will do is it'll align it horizontally, all of the shapes together, but you'll notice that it's not equal. So what we need to do is select horizontal center, and this will move it horizontally in the frame itself. Now, what I really wish that Premiere Pro would allow me to do is to vertically center it based on the space at the top and the bottom. When you do this, it just smushes all the layers in the center. So this is one thing I think Premiere Pro needs to work on, is we need to be able to allow the layers when they're all selected to be vertically centered, because right now it doesn't work in this case. So the next thing we need to do, and this is the new thing, it's over here, distribute vertically. So if we want the space between each of the lines to be equal, we can select distribute vertically. And look at that, everything is distributed evenly between each text element. So you can use this to be able to evenly distribute the objects, and then you can go on to stylize it like I did here. I added kind of a gray gradient from all of the different text layers. I added a darker fill in the beginning, and then it just gets lighter and lighter. And then I added a film impact animation transition to create something like this. It's not a super useful thing. I don't think I would use it that often, but if I'm making pattern graphics, I think it would come in handy. So the next update is a speed update. So if you're on a Mac OS M1 chip, or you're on a Windows with AMD, now when you export HEVC, I'm not sure how you say it or if we actually just spell out that acronym, it's now 10 times faster to export on those systems. If you don't have it, good luck. I did do a test on this laptop with a 10 minute and 30 second video. I exported at H.265 in 4K, and it took about 3 minutes and 25 seconds to do. So a little bit more than a quarter of the length of the video. Not bad at all, but H.264 is a lot faster still. The next update is improved QuickTime screen recording playback. I don't really use QuickTime screen recordings that often in Premiere Pro, but if this is a good update for you, thumbs up for me. It's kind of irrelevant, but it is here. The next update that Adobe is calling smart rendering is interesting, because it says it's supposed to smartly help speed up your exports, but it's only working for certain codecs and only if your timeline sequence settings match your source settings. So the catch is, it only works with certain codecs. So they actually put a full list of all the codecs that work with smart rendering. You can see DNX HD, MXF, animation, GoPro. So for all of the like higher res QuickTime wrapper codecs, all of that. But that's it. It's not clear what smart rendering is. It doesn't have a clear definition. There's nowhere in the export panel where it says smart rendering's turned on. It would just be nice to know when smart rendering is working when you're inside of the export window, because right now I don't see anything. And the last update is the HDR proxies. If you don't know what a proxy is, you can just watch this tutorial I made and you can get an in-depth look at how it works. All this new update does is it allows you to have HDR proxies. So that way your proxies will be in the HDR color space. So that way when you're, you know, editing your timeline, your proxies won't look different. If you work in HDR, I think this update is worth it. And one last reminder is, if you are currently working on a project right now, wait until you're done with the project before you update to the latest version. It's just a good common practice to have. And now it's time for product of the week. This week's product of the week is Nova AI. It's like the Google search, but for your footage. Imagine uploading all your footage to Nova AI. It'll log, it'll analyze it, it'll automatically apply tags to your footage to make it easily searchable. It'll also automatically subtitle your footage, and you can translate those subtitles subtitles into over 40 different languages, and there's some editing tools as well. Now, the translation part is really cool because I've always wanted to add more translations to my YouTube videos. So when I upload one of my YouTube videos to Nova AI, it'll automatically generate my English captions, and then I can go and select Spanish or French, and it will automatically translate it for me. I can download it as .srt files and then attach it on YouTube to have those translations. So you can use my link below to get 2 hours free to test out Nova AI with your own videos. It's a very new tool, so I'd love for you to try it out and give feedback to the team, because I think that there's a future here, the future of editing and the future of archiving your footage, because it would be so great if I could imagine all of my YouTube content in Nova AI and just remembering, oh, remember when I said hologram, and just searching the word hologram and having every instance when I mentioned hologram in any video and being able to just export that. That's what I think the value of Nova AI is. So link below, go check it out if you want to. Hopefully it's useful. So that's all for today's video. Thank you so much for watching. Let me know what you think about all the new updates, and be sure to give feedback below on what you'd like to see in Premiere Pro going forward. And as always, keep creating better video with GIF. See you next time. Bye.